Today in this tutorial, we are going to learn about how to use MongoDB and how to create schema in MongoDB. And schema means table. In MongoDB, we don't say it's table, we say it's schema. And guys, you have to download MongoDB. So here is the MongoDB's official site. So from here, you have to download. And here is the download option. So you have to click this button and you have to download MongoDB. So I will provide the link in description. And if you guys face any problem to download MongoDB, so then you can comment. I will make another video how to download MongoDB. And here I'm assuming that you have already downloaded MongoDB. So after downloading MongoDB, you have to open your C drive. So here I will open C drive, and here you have to create a data folder. The name is data. So you can see I already created a data folder, and inside this data folder you have to create a db folder. So I already created a folder and name is db, because guys, otherwise MongoDB will not be run. So guys, you have to do that thing. And after that, when you will be downloaded MongoDB, then after open C drive, and you have to go to program file, and here you will get a MongoDB folder, and then you have to open MongoDB server 4.2 and now bin, and here you will find a mongo file. So you have to open mongo file, and then you have to stay open it, don't close, and that and minimize. And after that, one software you have to download, that's called Roboto 3T. So here is the Roboto 3T, and I will provide the link of Roboto 3T in our description. So from there you can download. And this is easy to download, guys. That I think you will not be face any problem to download Roboto 3T. And here Roboto 3T, you can see the structure of your database inside this, in this Roboto 3T software. So you have to download this two software, MongoDB and Roboto 3T. So MongoDB used for database and Roboto 3T used to see the structure of our database. And now guys, after complete these two things, you have to install Mongoose. Mongoose is the connecting database. So to install Mongoose, you can go official site of Mongoose. So here you can type Mongoose. And then you have to click getting started. And you can see this is the official site of Mongoose. So here you can read the documentation. And now here is the installation command, install Mongoose. So now I will copy this command, and just here I will paste this command, and here I will just add --save to save it globally. And now it will take some time to install. So you can see MongoDB installation is completed. So now if you check your package.json file, so here you can see Mongoose. So Mongoose install is completed, and here inside this package.json file, you can see in the dependencies array, here is the dependencies array, and here is Mongoose is installed. And now here you have to create a folder. This is my project, node project, and just here you have to create a folder, and you have to write the name of this folder is MongoDB. And inside this MongoDB folder, you have to create a file. So here is the file option, and now this file name is connection.js. You can write any name of this folder and this file name as per your choice. So I write the name to related, because here I will write the connection code. So this file name is connection. You can write any name of this file. And now at first here I have to require Mongoose. So const, and variable name is Mongoose. Mongoose is the variable name. So this variable name, you can write any name also. And now here require the package is Mongoose. So when we require any package, then just inverted comma and we write Mongoose. So you can see here is the suggestion Mongoose. So I will click enter, and now just here I will add a semicolon to separate this line. And now Mongoose means this variable Mongoose. So Mongoose dot connect, and here parenthesis, and inside this parenthesis you have to write MongoDB colon double slash local host 27017. So you have to write this localhost 27017. So this is the default port of MongoDB. So you have to write this 20710. So if you find this Mongo file which I open, so here you will find this port. So here you can see that this is the port, default port to run MongoDB. So here you have to write this port number, and now here you have to write the name of your database, which name you want to write. So I want to write here block, the database name. You can write any name of this database, which name you want to create database. And now here inside this curly braces, here you have to write URL use new URL parser and true. So this is the syntax to write. So here I am getting error because I forgot to add comma. And now you can see this line is for create database. And now here I will write then. So I will zoom out so you will understand that you can see that this line. Now again I will zoom in it, and now here you have to write dot then and parenthesis. Here you have to pass a parameter response. Okay, response and arrow function, and now console dot log, and here I will pass simple message MongoDB is connected. This is for checking MongoDB is connected or not. And now here dot catch error and here console log MongoDB is not connected, or you can write a connection error. So that will be better. Here I will write error connection. This is the better. And now MongoDB connection code is done. So first of all, connection.js, I will close this file because it's completed. And now here I will create a folder inside this our node project folder. So here the folder name is user, because all the details of user I will store inside this user folder. So I will create a folder and the name is user. And so now here I will create user schema. User schema means when user will be registered, his name, email, etc. So for here we have to create a schema of that. So let's see the practical example. So inside this user folder I will create a file, and the file name is user model. You can write any name of this file. So here user model, so you can call it schema or model. So the related name is I found it user model, so I named it user model. You can write any name of that. And now I will go to the official side of Mongoose. So here is the Mongoose site, and now you can see the left side panel schemas option. So I will click this schema, and now I will scroll, and here you can see the structure of schema. So just I will copy this, and here just I will paste. And now you can see it's require Mongoose package first of all, and then it's taken a variable. The name variable name is schema, and inside the schema variable it's taken Mongoose dot schema. So that's the syntax of create schema. And now it's taken another variable, variable name is block schema, and create a object new schema, and this is the structure of schema. Structure means, guys, when user register, then we can take a different types of field: username, email ID, password, confirm password, different types of fields. So that's the input field structure. So here I will show you only two input field: email and password. So just I will remove this input fields from here, and I will also remove the comment line also. And here instead of title I will write as email, and here I will write a password. You can write any name of this input field which you want to take in from user details. And now this is the type. So string, email is string and password is string. So the strings S is the capital form. And now this schema structure is ready, but this file I need to user queries file. When I will write a user query, that means MongoDB's query, so then register query, you can say it. So then I need to this file. So first of all I have to export, otherwise I can't import this file in any other file. So first of all I have to export. So first, here I will write a variable. Variable name is register info. You can write any variable name, but here I am defined the register user register schema structure. So I had written the register info, the similar name, and now here I have to write mongoose dot model. So you can call schema or model also, but we didn't call it table. So mongoose dot model, you can call it model also. And now here inverted comma, and here you have to write the schema name. Schema name means your, you can say it, table name. So here I will write the table name is register. You can write any name of this table. And here I have to inside this register table, which table which I want to insert this email and password. So inside this email and password I define this block schemas variable. So just I will copy this block schema variable, and here I will pass it. And now this register info I have to export this table, because all the table schema structure I define now register info's variable. So just here I have to export this register info variable. So module dot exports equals to this register info and semicolon. So now everything is done, guys, and now in the next video I will show how to write user query and how to create routes, or you can say it API. So hope, guys, this video is helpful to you, and if you want to get more videos in Node.js, then you can subscribe and press the notification bell icon also.